8 years after being abducted, raped, and forced into marriage, Elizabeth Smart is reliving the horror on the witness stand as she testifies against the man accused of those crimes. Is live in Salt Lake City. Janet, first let me talk to you about the emotions. It's amazing, A, that she's 23 years old now. The years have gone by, but those memories are still pressed in that young girl's mind.
And for everybody in the room as well, Tamron, I can tell you that she is sitting up there poised and confident. But this is compelling testimony. Not finish up her testimony today, Tamron. It will probably go into tomorrow, and then the defense will get a chance to question her as well.
Janet, how long are they expecting this trial to last? After all, she's waited these many years for justice here. Emily in live for us in Salt Lake City, Utah. Thanks, Janet. Well, a nationwide sting turns the spotlight on the unimaginable crime of child prostitution in this country. The three-day operation resulted in an arrest of 99 suspected pimps and more than 800 other adults charged with sexually exploiting minors. Welcome back to News Nation, the search for answers. An innocent teenager is savagely attacked and killed by a group of other teens. And now that boy's mom wants justice. And President Obama is today's News Nation gut check. And a Georgia woman is in mourning today after her 18-year-old son was beaten and kicked to death outside of a house party. This happened over the weekend. Bobby Tillman. President Obama is now in Indonesia, as we report at the top of the hour, where he's hoping to improve U.S. relations with Muslims in the world's most populous Muslim nation. There are some reports that the president has lost support with moderate Muslims since that speech he gave in Cairo in 2009. What do you find here, this relationship to be at this point?
More skepticism now than he did back in Cairo.
How much of the skepticism comes from the fact that he's added more troops on the ground in Afghanistan? Words into action, which is obviously the challenge he has here, even on domestic issues. But he says we're not going to completely eliminate some of the misunderstandings and mistrust that have developed. I erase all things, but you can try to improve. But with the challenges this president has domestically, over the next 2 years, is it even really possible? And skepticism that exists here about his ties to the Muslim community.
Well, it's going to be very...
All right, Bobby, thank you very much. Great having you on. Good to see you. I haven't seen you in a while. Well, election workers...